Lynch founder helped settle not one, but two disputes between Maryland and Virginia. Hi, founder fans, Jason here, and today's founder is a man named Alexander Henderson. Alexander Henderson moved from Scotland to Virginia when he was just 18 years old, and he opened up a shop. And what's interesting about his shop is it was a mercantile house, but instead of doing what most merchants did, which was buy massive amounts of products from plantations on credit and ship them to Europe, where they would sell them and bring the money back, he actually purchased from local farmers. And he also sold many regular household products, kind of like a general store, and he would allow people to barter with him. So in a way, he established his own line of credit between the local farmers and his customers, and he was the mediator. And over the course of his life, he would actually go on to establish four separate stores, and it's been argued that he is the father of the American chain store, although I don't think this is true. Really, the first chain store, to my understanding, was A&P in the early 1900s, who had hundreds of locations and not just four, but I did want to put that out there that he has been, in certain circles, given that credit. Now, when the Revolutionary War broke out, he did participate a little bit. He joined the militia briefly, and he also served in the Virginia House of Delegates after statehood. But mostly, he spent the war tending to his small business. Because it was a small business, he couldn't just leave it and let it work itself, so to speak. And before you get upset at him, many people during the American Revolution did exactly this. But what's really important about Alexander Henderson is in 1775, just as the war was breaking out, he was actually chosen by Virginia to go to a meeting that discussed borders on the Potomac between Maryland and Virginia. And he and several Virginians met with several Maryland citizens, and they discussed exactly what should be done about this border dispute. And it was important for Alexander Henderson because as someone who had his shop on the Potomac, he had customers from both states. At that time, both colonies. And they did negotiate for a week, and they were able to resolve the border dispute. And I do like to point out the first complaint that the American revolutionaries had in the Declaration of Independence to the king is that he refused to assent of laws, instead of paraphrasing, I'll just read it. I have it right here. He has refused to assent to laws the most wholesome and necessary for the public good. In essence, he hasn't been caring for the laws that are important. And things like this border dispute were very important for the king to settle between colonies. But since Alexander Henderson and friends got together and settled this dispute on their own, it indicated to them and the other colonies, hey, we could take care of these issues by ourselves without just going to war, which seemed to happen from time to time between colonies. They didn't usually go to war, but every once in a while, hostilities broke out. So they demonstrated that they could do this. Now, a decade goes by and the revolution happens and the war is won. And then in 1785, a full decade later, another conference is called. This one's called the Mount Vernon Conference and takes place at George Washington's house, who was enjoying his retirement between being commander of the Continental Army and the President of the United States. So Virginia again sends several delegates, including Alexander Henderson, not Hamilton, I keep wanting to say that, Alexander Henderson, and George Mason, and they go and meet with Thomas Stone, Daniel of St. Thomas Jennifer, and one more Virginian, whose name escapes me, Samuel Chase. And the three of them, the three Marylanders, meet with these Virginians. Washington was there because it was his house, but he wasn't officially a member. And they had a discussion about improving the Potomac. And I talked a little bit about this in our live video yesterday, but they negotiated, how can we work together to improve the Potomac? And they came to an agreement after a week of discussion, and then the people from Maryland went back to Maryland, and the people from Virginia went back to Virginia, and both colonies approved this agreement. I'm sorry, both states at this point approved this agreement. And they were working together. They also sent information to Delaware and Pennsylvania to see if they wanted to join in on the fun. Now, 2 years after this, they wrote the United States Constitution, and one of the reasons they did is because they looked and said, hey, we've been now resolving these issues ourselves for over 10 years, but again, our complaint with the king is he should help us with this, and maybe we should have a stronger central or federal government to help take care of these issues so we don't need these states to ratify them separately. We could just have one body where the representatives of the states go and meet and hash it out there. And that's why The Mount Vernon Conference, as it was called, became very integral in the later development of the Constitution and the United States as we know it today. And Alexander Henderson, today's hero, was at both the first one in 1775 and the second meeting between these two states in 1785. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned a little bit about Alexander Henderson, whose name I keep wanting to say Alexander Hamilton, but that's not true. I'm just excited for the upcoming release of the play on Disney+. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit like. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel. You heard me mention earlier, we do a live video for about an hour, hour and a half every Wednesday at 8:15 Eastern, where we discuss the revolution and the articles I wrote in the previous week. So if that interests you, please come on board. And I put out four videos like this one the other weekdays. So thank you again for watching, and I'll be back with another founder tomorrow.